And now, Blonde Wave for Parallel presents Cooking with Blonde Wave. This episode, Aaron Salmon and Amushta Potatoes.
Hey everybody, Cooking
with
Blonde
Wave.
Hey guys! Shane, what are you doing? I have the hat.
I don't know.
And we're doing a different dish, and this is one of mine.
Yes, very excited. Aaron talks about this all the time.
And Calvin's sharpening a knife for us to use. All right, so with this, we're gonna be having salmon with like a seafood potato. It's kind of like a potato mash thing. Yeah. Anyway, I don't have a name for that. I'll come up with it later.
Yeah.
But we have our salmon. And then we have potatoes. This time we're actually using red potatoes. I have garlic, as well as an onion, red onion. And then I have green onions and chives. Crab meat's a little hard to find in Ohio. And if you find it, it's pricey. So this is actually a faux crab. So it's technically Alaskan pollock, but it's supposed to be crab. First thing we need to do is clean up your potatoes. We're gonna clean these up and then we're gonna boil them. So let's do that. These ones have already been rinsed off, right, Shane?
Yeah.
So while they clean up some of these other potatoes, because we might, with all of us, we'll probably end up eating.
Yep.
I would assume all of these.
Probably.
And I'll
what
start.
Say that.
I'll start boiling these.
Can't we have you, Eric?
Nothing, Eric. Don't worry about it.
What are you saying?
Not too much.
You tough man.
It's your
favorite
candy.
It's my house, bitch.
Favorite candy. So I'm gonna get this ready to go to a boil.
Motherfucker. Should have boiled already.
I put the potatoes in here already. One thing I often do is salt and pepper the boiling water to help give some little seasoning around with it.
Also lowers the boiling temperature of H2O.
And I'm gonna put in some pepper.
Will they fit?
They may all fit.
That's what she said. Did she, Calvin? Did she say that?
While these boil, we'll start preparing our salmon. This one is a fresh salmon.
How fresh?
I mean, it's
never frozen fresh.
Never frozen, so that's fairly fresh.
How can you tell when your fish is starting to get a little old?
I don't know, Shane, how?
You can tell because it starts to get sticky and slimy.
Oh, this feels good.
Yeah, it feels good. And it bounces back.
So the first thing we need to do with that one is descale it.
Aaron's had the most experience with descaling fish, so letting him do it.
If it has a little bit of a bend to it, that's not too bad either. You're just basically going against the grain.
Yeah.
These are going to be the hardest parts of the side pieces.
Yeah.
Try and get as much as you can off of these. Now, try to be careful because if you go too, you don't want to push too much at the same time.
You'll get some of the meat.
Well, you'll dig into the meat, you could bruise the meat, you could just cut it by accident.
I've always found it helps to do it at a more oblique angle. It'll catch the edge, it'll peel it up.
Yeah.
And then
pulls it off.
Pulls it out, like pulls it up and out rather than just straight across.
So rather than having like a sharp angle on it.
Rather than
like
having a sharp edge, I prefer having a more. And then the ones that are loose, go back through, pull them out straight. Yeah.
This is probably the longest process of the whole thing.
Yeah.
Either between that and actually boiling the potatoes.
Yeah.
Are the two things that take the longest of this whole process. Actually, with the potatoes too, one thing you can do is have, like if you have boiled potatoes from like yesterday, you had boiled potatoes and like that, you can use those for this as well. They don't have to be like freshly boiled right now.
Yeah.
So if you had anything to make this process faster, what would it be, Aaron?
A fish descaler.
Yeah. Which we could not find. I don't have one, and Aaron couldn't find one at the store, so we got Calvin.
I did this with a pocket knife one time. It took like an hour.
Yeah.
Like a small half the size too.
If you don't want to go through this process, you could do it with frozen salmon if you want to. This one's just fresh salmon.
Pre-skinned.
Yeah.
So where do you think this was caught at and when?
Fresh Atlantic salmon product of Chile contains fish.
Ah.
And once we're done with this, we just need to cut it into like four pieces.
So me, Calvin, Aaron.
Glad we rinsed this because the piece of foil fell out of the fish.
Oh yeah, getting your...
That was already there. Look!
We're gonna cut this into pieces. So there's one piece. Alright, then we need...
Pretty much
right there.
Equal portions here and here.
One of the first things we're gonna do is score the fish. Which is basically we're gonna be cutting along the top here. Just a little bit into there. You don't need to go too deep.
Just about a quarter to 3/8 of an inch deep.
Mm-hmm. And what this will do is stop, when we're cooking the fish, it'll stop it from kind of curling up.
Because the skin shrinks more than the actual meat of the fish does.
Yes. And if you want to be real smart like us, do this in a colder environment, and every once in a while throw some ice on your fish if you're going to be in room temperature for more than 30 minutes.
So this is what I do when I make calzones.
Somewhat, yeah.
Kind of, yeah.
It's the same principle.
You want those little cuts on the top. Starting to get down to the bottom of this fish, so I don't have as much room to go down through, but I'm still going to try to just cut it a little bit.
Gentlemen, I got to go pick up my kids.
Okay.
My daughter got sick, and my son gets off of basketball practice in like 20 minutes.
Okay.
Talk to you a little bit, guys.
All right, we'll see you soon, Shane.
Yep.
See you, Shane.
Sir.
You looking forward to that, Greg?
All right, now that Shane is gone, what are we really making?
Hey!
You turned her against me!
You have done that yourself!
Damn!
That'd be funny if he said that.
Damn! Guess you're right.
Damn it!
All I right. Should have killed those children.
It's a prequel thing.
I get it. You wouldn't understand.
You probably get it.
Maybe when you're old.
You guys aren't funny.
Oh.
You get better material.
Oh.
It's the original trilogy. I shouldn't antagonize Calvin with a knife, should I?
I don't know. I don't mind it. You should. I think you should. It'd be funny.
Cool. Calvin's like prequels.
He's been properly schooled.
He's up there.
Alright, potatoes are looking good.
Potatoes are boiling finally. It's not a full roll.
So what we'll start with these is we're gonna season the fish.
Yes.
I'm gonna do salt, a little bit of pepper, probably some garlic powder on here. And if you can, try to get it inside where the cut marks where you scored. And then you can get your seasoning in there and it helps flavor the meat a little bit there. And then when you just kinda toss a little bit of salt on there and kinda rub it in a little bit.
Just tap it in?
Just tap it in. Damn gator got my hand! I got his eye right here. The seasoning for the salmon is going to be salt, pepper, and then for me, I like garlic powder as well.
Yes.
Having someone else that can like sprinkle and you can help spread those makes it easier.
Yeah.
That's why I like having that, because then you can use both hands.
And not have to worry about getting your grinder messy.
So now pepper.
Yeah, a little bit of pepper. Now we kind of need to wait on the potato a little bit.
Well, I don't want
to. Well, that's too damn bad.
I'm not waiting.
The only other things we could do is we can prepare the onions and chives and crab meat.
Now, the crab meat you actually want to shred, right?
I've done it where it's kind of shredded. I've also done it where I just have just chunks.
Like chopped chunks?
Yeah.
Like cubed?
Like I've had, like these ones are actually in like sticks and I've actually just like cut them into like little pieces.
Okay.
Like
little sticks?
Yeah. Like shorter sticks.
Yeah.
Not as long. So you can do that.
Like when you cut up a hot dog.
Kind of, yeah.
Why would you cut up a hot dog? Just eat it.
For little kids.
Just eat it whole.
No, little kids that can choke.
Pussies.
The garlic.
Garlic.
We're actually not gonna chop.
No.
What we're gonna do is peel it off.
Just eat it whole.
Kind of. And now that our water is boiling, we're actually going to toss in several pieces of garlic into boiling water.
Whoa.
What does that do, Aaron?
I'm getting there.
Just trying to give you a...
For luck, Calvin.
Thank you, Calvin, for asking.
That's nothing.
What we're going to do with that is it's going to soften up the piece of garlic here. And
why is that good, Aaron?
And then when we get into our next step for the mashing part... It's actually gonna blend in with our potatoes.
We're gonna mash potatoes?
Oh,
that's my favorite candy!
My favorite candy. Oh shit, I caught it. I'm probably gonna put in about 4 or 5.
So many. Calvin? Calvin?
I found a pot lid!
Should we put the fish in the fridge while we let that finish boil?
Wouldn't hurt. Let's triple foil it.
Shit.
Come fire, yeah. Oh.
They're almost there. While we're waiting on the potatoes to finish up, I'm going to begin preparing the other ingredients that are going in the potatoes. All this stuff up to here, I consider being usable, and the rest I've not used.
Depends on whether I make, like, a soup or stew or, like, a...
For boiling, like, the root of it and stuff?
Yeah, like, actually, like, imbibing the... Not imbibing. What's the word I'm looking for?
Embalming.
Infusing?
Infusing.
Embalming.
The actual...
The death! Go ahead and you can chop up those. Then we're going to get some chives in there as well. Then also, sometimes I use parsley in this as well, but I do not have any parsley. You don't necessarily need it. But it's something you can use. You think we don't need that part?
I've just been doing it by color.
That's fine. Part where it kind of loses the green, turns more white.
Yeah.
Ooh, yes. These are feeling good. Some of the bigger ones are still a little stiff.
That's too bad.
Good. Good. Now, basically, do the same thing with the chives. We're just going to slice those up as well. We'll get some of the onion prepared as well. Potatoes should be done by the time we finish chopping this stuff up, and then we'll move on to the last parts of it.
Kevin!
You're wasting water!
Kevin!
It is very hot.
Kevin!
Alright. The, colander.
Colander?
Yes.
Strainer?
Colander.
Wait, strainer, colander, whichever.
You can see the, garlic cloves down there. Don't pick them up. There.
Hot. All right. And then the last thing we're really going to need out of this is going to be this onion.
A whole onion?
I don't know. I might not throw in the whole onion, but just some onion.
Okay.
We'll already have some green onions, and then we're tossing a little bit of red onion. Last time I did this with a yellow onion, and it was good with that as well.
Sweet onion.
Toss these on a plate. They can mix it fine. They don't have to be separated or anything.
At this point,
keep them separated.
You gotta keep them separated. Come out and play! And the best thing to try to do too is to have like...
Three fingers down.
Three fingers, and then use this finger to try to guide your knife.
That looks like plenty of onion.
Yep, it should be good. With that, our chives, our green onions, we have plenty of potato over here. This is just, this here at this point is preference as far as how big of chunks you want in your potatoes.
Now I'm really fucking crying.
Good. A little bit of olive oil to the bottom. And then we're gonna put our potatoes back in here. And if we had had these, right now they're still warm, still mushy and stuff. If these were like potatoes that we'd had yesterday that weren't finished and whatnot, like old baked potato, day old boiled potato, if they were in the fridge, we'd be warming them up in this process. But they're already warmed up, so we're basically gonna use this just to finish mixing all of our ingredients together. We can put this on a lower temperature.
Medium to low.
Mm-hmm. With this, all you really need is a fork. Put in and just kind of twist our forks in them. We're not going to actually mash the potato, but we're going to kind of smush it up. And yeah, it's going to be kind of like a chopped potato a little bit. And then what you'll end up with is kind of this mashed potato that have a little bit of smaller chunks, bigger chunks and everything into it. And with this one having the red potatoes, you'll have your red skins in there too, which is good for you as well.
Now, in my experience, this is where you would add all the sugar.
Sugar? What sugar? And with this too, the garlic is also fairly soft, so you can just put them in there and you just do the same thing and you can just mush it within your potatoes. So you're gonna have that garlic in there mushed in with your potatoes, giving it a garlicky flavor.
You should call these mooshed potatoes.
Mooshed?
Because you keep saying mushed. And not
if you had mashed. if you had a potato masher, you just went over each potato like once or twice without actually like
a couple mooshes.
Yeah, just a couple mooshes. Depressions.
Yeah, with this, I don't like saying mashed potato because I don't feel like they're really mashed potatoes.
Yeah, they're not.
Even though
they're not completely pulverized.
Yeah.
They're just
mooshed.
Stepped on.
Yeah, a lot of people think of mashed potatoes. They want like kind of like that.
The creamier
with maybe like a little bit of chunk here and there.
But not here,
no. These aren't going to be the nice creamy.
Moosh.
Like, I'm not putting in butter and milk to try to get these to be soft or anything.
Kind of make them just a little moosh.
Yeah, I was thinking you should probably crush the garlic against the side. That way you make sure and get them good.
Good and mooshed.
Because,
Well, yeah, so you miss them in the potatoes?
Yeah. Because by the time you get those all crushed up to the same scale that the potatoes are, there's going to be larger chunks of garlic in there.
And it wouldn't be very well mooshed.
You're probably correct, Calvin. We're going to put a little bit more olive oil over the top of these.
Okay.
so they mush better.
Mush.
Mush.
I also don't use butter on these.
No.
We're not, the olive oil should give enough of that kind of like the same thing the butter does, and then we also are gonna season it, and we also gonna have the crab. Speaking of which, Calvin, while I finish up getting these, do you wanna cut the crab into pieces so we have it to add in here soon? I personally like to add in a little bit of extra garlic powder too, just to help kind of balance it out in case the garlic doesn't get spread out everywhere. It gives everything kind of a little bit of a garlicky taste.
Get a little moosh in there.
Get a little moosh. One thing he needs as well is coriander. It kind of gives a lemony kind of taste a little bit.
Yeah.
Which kind of works well with seafood typically. So we'll put this, a little bit of this in with our potatoes.
Moosh.
Just have it blend with the salmon and the crab meat a little bit.
Get all those tastes, like this moosh together.
Yes, we'll moosh.
Clean.
Now, if you wanted to, you could add in some butter to the potatoes. Because with having the crab meat, which goes good with butter, and potatoes that typically go well with butter.
Butter.
It can work. So we're just gonna put the crab meat in with the potatoes. We'll moosh that around.
Moosh it.
While we're doing that, we'll also take the chives and the green onions. Toss that in there and moosh it around.
Moosh it.
You can mix it with a fork or with your hand, depending on how...
Temperature?
Yeah.
How hot it may be.
Or you can play Sir Mix-a-Lot at incredible volume, just like we're gonna do now. I like big butts and I
cannot lie. So we have all the onions, the chives, the crab meat. Calvin's doing some more crab meat. If we wanted to, we could eat that on the side too. This one here should already be cooked. But we can also, if we wanted to, warm it up in a pan and have it kind of like just a seared crab meat. And then we'll just kind of mix this up. You thought I was going to say mush. Ah, ha, 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 ha. Got him.
Mush.
Most of the potato now is already done. We may add a little bit more salt, a little bit more pepper, such, but.
And this is called?
This is the thing I don't really have a name.
Mooshed potatoes.
I've called it apparently mooshed potatoes or crab potatoes.
Mooshed
or seafood
crab potatoes.
Seafood potatoes or
I like sea potatoes.
Mooshed crab potatoes.
Sea potato salad.
Sea potato salad.
It's kind of like a warm potato salad, is what it's kind of like. A little bit.
Oh yeah, jump on this mooshed thing.
Mooshed potatoes.
Right. Yeah, we'll start a whole brand. Mooshed crab potatoes. Mm-hmm. Mooshed butter. Mooshed Sir Mix-a-Lot.
I'm gonna do a little bit more pepper, a little bit more salt. Just add, and then we can add it on to when we get it to the plates as we see fit. We're gonna start our pan up, put some olive oil in there. I'm gonna get my fish. I'm also going to try to drizzle a little bit of olive oil on top of the fish as well. At home, I have a little like olive oil like drizzler thing. Makes it a little bit easier to try to.
Oh, it's like a wine bottle with one of the... Yeah.
I have a fish slice, but I have a spatula we'll be using. If you have a fish slice, I would recommend using it, because it just makes it easier to flip it.
It's a lot better. It's specifically designed and shaped for that.
Yeah.
Twist it!
Now, whenever I first...
Now slice it!
...was kind of wanting to learn how to cook and stuff, it kind of stemmed from fish, because Melanie loved tilapia.
Yeah.
And salmon, and I would put it in the pan, and it would cook, and fall apart, and stick, and become a mess. Or terrible. I was never sure like how long to cook it, like when it was done. I didn't want to have raw fish.
Yeah.
So this is
she'd probably never eat it again.
This is one of the first things that I started trying to learn. And the first time I did this recipe, after kind of learning how to do it, Melanie had been working, and she came home, and I was like, "Here you go. I made this for you." And she's like, "Okay." And then she tried it, and then she was asking where it came from. She thought that maybe I went to like Applebee's, bought salmon, and threw away the packaging.
TLDR, she didn't believe he could.
She didn't believe it was me. So, with this being all set and ready, this pan should be getting nice and hot. Pick up our fish.
And this is a very important bit.
And we're gonna lay it skin down, okay? It should be nice and warm where you hear that. Just kind of push it down.
Make sure all the skin bits are touching.
So it's all even. As far as cooking fish, you only really need to flip it once. You're gonna watch it as it cooks in the skin till about 2/3 of the way of the color change.
it's going to start turning more of a pink color. Once it gets about two-thirds of the way, you'll flip it over. We'll cook the other side of it, and then you'll
pretty much
done.
Just a sear.
Now with this one, it's more of a crispy, like, skin. So I'll actually flip it back over and let it sit just a little bit longer on the skin part of it. But other than that, that's going to be it. Now during this time, since we seasoned the top, we could season the bottom of the fish. So Calvin, if you want to... Garlic powder and pepper, and I have some salt here. I can sprinkle some salt on the top here.
Okay.
There's a little bit of salt.
A little bit of pepper.
Pepper, and then I sprinkle some garlic powder on the top of that as well. And as you'll see, as we cook more, it's going to slowly change
that,
colors.
That white discoloration is going to slowly climb off the surface of the pan.
Mm-hmm. Now, with what we did with the potatoes, too, like I said, the crab meat we had was already cooked. So this isn't really about cooking the crab meat. So if you're using this stuff, you should be good. If you're using other crab meat, just make sure you boil it or whatever you need to do to prepare it the way you want it before putting it into this dish. All right, hopefully this will work all right for me here. I'm gonna try to get under this here.
Very nice.
I might not even need to actually
whip
it back over for the crispy side.
Yeah.
We'll let it cook the rest of the way and kind of change the color on the rest of the fish here. And then we should be good on this piece here. Now with the potatoes, one last thing we're going to try to sprinkle on the top of it a little bit is a vinaigrette, which is why we have these little like spritz bottle things. All the vinaigrette's going to be is water.
Natural spring water only. And I will collect that right now. You're asking it!
The rats are getting out!
Kevin!
Not again! We good? You good?
I have a cramp.
We're good.
And we're using water, olive oil, and lemon juice.
Yep.
As well as salt and pepper. So if you want
to... Now, do you have any preference on proportions, or do you just want me to guess?
Not on this one. This, actually, I've never actually tried.
Okay.
This was in the original recipe, and Melanie doesn't really care for this kind of stuff. So we're going to try this with this one today. Typically, I would just kind of give it a little bit of a glaze of just some olive oil, maybe, and that's it.
What if it sucks?
Well, then we just won't put a whole lot on. We have our potatoes here on our plate. We have our fish. I'll turn this off right now until I get doing the next piece. So there's that.
Ooh, smells good.
A little bit, a little crispy on top. I probably could have still flipped it over and let it cook a little bit more. Also, there's another technique that I might use on these. I didn't do on this to help cook kind of the this little side piece here. I'll actually tilt usually in the olive oil and let it cook a little bit more.
I thought only gamers tilted.
Usually you do when you play games.
What? Only when I'm playing versus you.
Water.
Water.
Lemon juice.
Lemon juice.
Salt, olive pepper, oil. Olive oil. Okay. I'm just adding what I guess to be roughly equal parts salt and pepper, 3 parts water, 1 part lemon juice, and 1 part olive oil. Now, it could look a little bit milky because the olive oil is mixing with the water and the lemon juice, but that's your vinaigrette. That's our vinaigrette, anyway.
Ooh, that crunchy skin. Perfect. Mmm.
It's just past. Like, you don't want your fish overcooked, but you don't want it to, like, fall apart.
Mm-hmm.
It's, like, right there.
Right in the middle there?
Perfect.
Ooh.
Very good.
It's actually one of my favorite things to cook now, probably.
Because it's remarkably easy once you know the tricks.
Once you know how to do it, it's really easy to do. So, like, and
it
actually...
Doesn't, it doesn't take that much time.
No, and last time I cooked salmon, Melanie ended up buying trout. I just cooked it the same way. It tasted great.
Yeah.
So, as far as I know, for most fish, you can kind of cook them the same way.
But I guess Shane might not be able to come back.
It's possible.
And hey, Aaron, can you please bring me mailbag and cooking? I probably shouldn't leave the house because Leona is very sick.
Okay.
And they said, Aaron, do you want to bring me a plate? Please, please, hello.
Please, please! Please. I know the sound.
Yeah. Please, please!
Please!
Very, very good.
Any thoughts of anything else you'd want to add or change or remove or...
I don't know. The texture is just kind of... It all muddles together because it's all fairly...
Moosh together.
Muddles together. It's like you can't exactly distinguish one... Alright, moosh. They're indistinguishable, really, from each other, but the tastes are still there. Mm-hmm. It's like, I can tell this bit is this potato, this bit is seafood, this bit is salmon, you know, but... I don't know that I would really change anything. It's just delicious. You can take any amount of any of it, and it's always good.
Yeah, like you could just eat the potatoes if you wanted to as your meal. You wouldn't even need the fish.
You wouldn't even need it.
You should just kind of, just put a little bit on there. If it's good, good. If not, we'll never use it again.
Yeah. It might not be. Might be too salty. Might be too lemony. In which case, I'm going to eat it anyway. Oh, shit, dude.
Better with it?
It's really fucking subtle, but it's there.
Mm-hmm.
It should
kind of lift the flavors a little bit.
Yeah, it really does.
I've never done it because Melanie's always like, I don't know if I'm going to like it, so I don't try it.
It's like Monster and then Monster with Emberry.
Eric, this is yours.
Yeah.
And immediately just pull the top off. Don't do that. That's...
It's my turn.
No. Aaron, what are you doing?
It's my turn.
Oh, okay. Good.
I'm just seasoning my fish.
Ah! I would put a decent amount on. Yeah.
Yeah, okay. All right. Okay, let's try it. Nice. Aaron, come here.
Oh, so
good.
Wow.
This is real good.
It's really good, huh?
It's real good. The fish, combine that with the mooshed potatoes. I'm loving it.
The mooshed potatoes.
I might go with a little more of that vinaigrette. Whatever that shit is.
Vinaigrette?
Yeah.
Use it.
A little bit more. Here we go. There we go, NASA.
Broken.
Oh, NASA. Oh.
No, I approve.
Good?
Good. Especially after a day of not eating. This is pretty great.
Perhaps it wouldn't be as good if we weren't starving. I don't know.
I don't know. Only one way to find out. Do it again tomorrow. I love it, Aaron.
Good.
You've done well.
You want something great, too.
No, the secret is that Aaron actually went to Captain D's!
This is a crispy salmon with, I guess, mooshed potatoes.
Mooshed crab potatoes.
So, if you try this at home, hopefully you enjoy it. Like I said, you can try any kind of potatoes. You can do this with pretty much any kind of fish if you really want to. And then, have fun with it. There's one more other kind of potato I have that I really enjoy making. This is like, I have two favorites. This is one, mm-hmm. I have one other. Mm-hmm. So maybe we'll do that again at some point. That's it. We'll see you guys next Cooking with Vlog.
Who are you?
I'm Eric.
Oh, you're Chef Eric.
Huh.
I'm Cameraman Eric.
A Hungry Man Eric.
Who are you?
I'm Calvin.
Ah!
Thank you for watching Cooking with Blind Waves. If you enjoy this kind of stupid shit.
And they're supporting us on Patreon.
That's the end card right there.
Oh, yeah.